back, Sinful Boy here. Today I'm playing a new game called The Bonfire. It's available on Android, which is what my phone is. So the premise of the game is that your main character lives somewhere, and you have to draw more people to them. Okay, so I think it's, yeah, you land here, and it's like a blizzard happening. So the first thing you need to do is to grab firewood from the nearby trees, once you have control over the character. Okay, so gather wood. It takes maybe a minute or two before you're able to create the bonfire. In the meantime, you're just putting the wood into the shed there that's already built on the land. I believe it's 5 pieces of wood before you can build the bonfire. But once you do, you'll have people coming. Oh, so it's 3 wood. The bonfire can be seen from miles away. That's what draws the people to you, and where you can start building a community, like a village. In the meantime, you want to continue to gather wood, because the next thing you need to do is, I believe it's called the mill. Or a farm or something. Yeah, farm. So you need 10 wood for that. And then as the people come, you can assign them tasks. So it's good to have at least one when you start out to be the guard. So these two, I would suggest putting one as the guard and the other as the wood gatherer. And then when you have a guard, that's when during the day the guards sleep in the shed. At night time they come out and patrol the area. As you see, I did not put them both as the guards. I believe the next group of people, one of them does become a guard. In the meantime, I'm putting as much wood in the shed as I can. And once you do have the farm, have at least one person start to gather the food from it. So the first night I decided to go ahead and work at the farm and allow my people to sleep in there. And you have to click each time what you want to do, because your main character does not do anything on his own. You have to direct him to do everything. Or her, if depending on what your story, what you want for the story. My character is a guy though, but you can see there's the jacket, hat, and scarf, so I guess it can be a female under there. So I'm still working throughout the night because my character doesn't sleep, or the main character does not sleep at all. That's the benefit of that character. Everyone else has to be assigned jobs though, so they can get everything up and running. You see at the bottom there, it says workers 2 of 10. You want to build houses to increase that number. And every night, or yeah, every night, I believe, you have to go with the tags, which is what the guards are for. And you see up at the top, you have the skin from the monster or the beast or whatever they're called, along with some meat. I believe later on in the game you can craft the skins into clothing or something. Kind of like Banished or any other games, kind of like these. Now I did go ahead and buy this game in the App Store or the Google Play Store, which is what that's called there, because I had a lot of fun with this one, so you'll be sure to see this game continuously on my channel. Okay, so yeah, so far I got one farmer, which is my main character, and I gave this one his torch to be a guard, and the other one is doing a wood gatherer. So this person here, he brings a cart, but he leaves again to look for his family. In the meantime, you can use the cart in order to have more, be more productive as far as getting items to where they need to go. So you had to go into the person's menu and equip the cart onto the person before they can use it. I had a little trouble at first figuring that out. And it'll be under the parry item, as you see there. So the reason I was going to say windmill earlier is you can see on the screen that the farm is a windmill, so that's where I got a little bit confused from. I don't know if there's any more seasons other than the winter season or not, but it was a blizzard before and now it's raining. But the grounds, to me at least, still looks like it has snow on it. I could be wrong though, but the river you can see over the log bridge is moving. So it's probably not as cold as it was before. Okay, here comes more people. At least one. If I remember, I put that one as the guard as well. Because after each night goes through, the enemy starts to getting a little bit stronger. Okay, let's, I don't remember. I think I've made him a card. Or maybe it's, at the moment, just one of each. And at that point, I just let the person go. I don't remember if he comes back or not, though. thief was beaten to death, so that wolf thing had gotten him instead. I forgot about that. I'm recording the voiceover after I've recorded the main playing, and that was maybe a week or two ago, so I don't remember what all I did in the game. So I'm watching it back and recording at the same time. Recording the voiceover, that is. At least I've got a lot of wood there. Okay, a workshop. I don't remember what that thing did. I think it's some kind of crafting items. Okay, so wooden spears and torches and stuff. Although you can do a torch beforehand as well. Yeah, this is kind of a slow-going game, so it's more like a casual type of game, if you need to de-stress or anything. It's pretty fun though, so I do recommend it. I also did a playthrough of The Bonfire 2, which is on Steam, I believe it was. Yeah, so look for that in the future. I did the demo version. Alright, so we have two more people showing up. Miak and Luka. So let's see what I did for that one. Two wood gatherers and two farmers, okay. As you can see there, the cart brought in five things altogether rather than just one. So I do recommend creating as many cards as you can at the beginning. That will help you immensely as far as gathering resources go. And I'm at the moment gathering more wood, as you see, because I want to be able to create spears and stuff. That'll be a major help as far as the monsters go. And I think here I'm going through and making one of these a guard, but I think they ended up going back to sleep again, like soon after. There is the attack right there. And any humor. I think soon there's gonna be like a spider monster type of thing. I'm not sure exactly what that is though. I saw that thing on a different person's playthrough, which is what made me want to get the game. Because that YouTuber I seem to be having fun with it, and I can't say that it is fun. Exhausting villagers once again. I believe that was the guard. I wonder if there's any attacks during the daytime, or if it's only at night. I haven't gotten that far into the game yet to really know. And here comes a couple more villagers. I think one of these I assigned as a guard as well, to have two guards. So you want the brave people to become the guards, and then the hard workers as the farmer and wood gatherers. Here I am creating more wood and torches. I mean, torches and spears. So I've got two of each, two guards, two farmers, and two wood gatherers. Along with myself, who can do any job that's there. So I've got room for four more people. In my next playthrough, I should see if I can build a house or not. I don't think so. I don't think there's a way to cure the people. I don't know for sure or not. Maybe that becomes unlocked later with maybe a medical type of thing or something. So let me know in the comments below if you want to see more of this game. And if you do, leave a like on the video as well. That helps me know what people like, so you can do that with every video on my channel, what content you want. Just go ahead and leave a like or comment in those places. And yeah, we have a lot of enemies this time around.